like an Orca spore killed him. Someone sabotaging operations like this. Well, it'd be interesting. The letter doesn't say who. Looking. Could still find out. Thank you. centipede spawning ground. Should destroy it.
Slow now.
Days pass.
Giddy up.
Thank you.
Just like...
Like who?
Like a pond. Gator, who are you thinking?
No matter. I suppose you thought nothing else in life could surprise you, eh? Wrong.
Hey, happen to know how the hell I can walk on that water?
Naturally, I know. Since time immemorial have I dwelt in solitude on this shore, and I can testify to the extraordinary nature of the lake.
What's so extraordinary about it? I mean, besides the fact that you can walk on its surface.
A sword, most wondrous, lies in its depths. I watch over it. The blade may be grasped solely by one who possesses the five chivalric virtues.
Folk call me a lot of things, but virtuous? I don't know.
Yet I do know. For I know who you are. You have proven yourself capable of great sympathy. You are a man of honor, as many can attest. Of humble means yourself. You show generosity to others. Your valor is the stuff of legends. Reason guides your actions, as it does those of all who are wise. You have proven the five chivalric virtues dwell in your heart.
Mean the sword's mine? I can dive in and take it?
The sword deserves the hand of a master. You must prove your skills are worthy through combat atop the water's surface. Are you ready?
Anytime.
Then draw your blade. Proven worthy of wielding the blade, beyond all doubt.
Behold, your Arendite.
We've met before.
Certainly. The hermit admitted he knew you, remember?
The Lady of the Lake.
It is I. Forget not that you are a man right and honorable, devoted to doing good. And for these reasons you received the blade. Now bear it. And I trust this time you shall not lose it.
Just wonderful.
drink! Give me a drink!
You make mountains out of molehills, Vilmar. I shall be better than fine.
I must insist, Count. You'll be much, much the safer with us at your side.
Baldish.
Count, if I may, I believe Vilmar's in there. There's no knowing what works.
They scoffed at you, the migrants from... But if you hadn't come...
Damn it.
run, Roach.
Thank you.
will sprout again. Should destroy the area if I want to get rid of them for good.
Those Vermentino folk.
Aye, and pigs can fly.
I thank you for the rescue. You're one fine fellow, Witcher.
Why don't you all just get off my back?
Greetings. To be honest, every last man Jack in these parts has but wine and wine.
When I was a young maid, we adhered to certain morals, as one should.
Women and chaps!
Morning.
The more you beat them, the better they are!
That's no time now.
Only my purse works.
Thank you. shown great faith.
I've no time.
So much we ought to have witches errant, not knights. None of that lot came forth to help us. To any knight and shout, "The beast!" You'll smell the soiled armor at once.
Munch, the whole of us, at once! You maggot-bummed freak!
Wide, heavy wheels. A merchant's wagon.
That's it, Roach. Show me what you got.
Says Great White Terror on the contract. Could be the same damn beast as in the notice, though. Dead. Just dead. Blow itself didn't kill him. Bled to death afterwards. What have we got here? No chance this letter wound up here by accident. Interesting. This note plus what I found earlier? Some third party's causing problems at the vineyards. Need to find the spot the letter mentions. Bet I'll find something mighty interesting behind whatever door this key opens.
Let's go. Giddy up. Let's go! Come on, Roach.
Dry as a stockfish.
My hand shakes so bad, I cannot hold my tools.
and I've caught some rot.
Let's go.
Is it true peasants can't carve his cows himself? Happy trails.
Abandoned, but a lot of this damage is recent. Guess I arrived just a little too late. Should look around still. Man, bled to death. Big beast inflicted these wounds, clear from the claw marks. Must have a toothy smile too, judging by what ripped his throat open. Blood. Of the fresh variety. Monster attack was recent. Signs of a fight. Paw prints, beastly ones, that's clear. Just on this spot, though. Aerial attack. Must have been. Draconid. Gotta be. Maybe a basilisk? Except these prints don't belong to any variety I know. Just a little different. Area's dangerous. I'd say there's a basilisk nesting around here. It'd be wise to remain at some distance.
Yes, I'm familiar with the matter, and quite proud to say a basilisk does nest here. I look after it personally.
Look after it? It's not exactly a pet. Beasts murdering folk who come through here.
Just a minute. It does not murder those who do not trespass upon its territory.
You post those warnings?
Indeed, to prevent anyone from coming to any harm.
Well, a lot of good they did. Got a freshly mangled corpse right here.
Most likely a merchant, the poor bloke. Just today, I learned two traders had chosen this route despite the signs. I came as quick as I could to warn them. Too late, alas. I've instructed my servants. They shall take the body, return it to the family with a generous sum as recompense.
Who exactly are you? And how'd you develop such an interest in the beast?
Count Borges, happy to be of service. As to the beast, well, this subspecies is our dynastic symbol. The Disalfareses have for centuries signed with the Regulus Platinum. As family legend has it, a female of the species rescued an ancestor, a boy at the time, from a burning building. She took the tyke back to her nest, where she fed him as if he were one of her own youngsters.
Malarkey.
To be sure, but beautiful malarkey it is.
The victim's family's compensation? Why?
These lands have been my family's for decades, granted to us by Duchess Ademarta. Beyond them, the basilisk ventures not, hunts not, it does not kill or destroy. Provided it is not provoked. Yet if it does destroy, if it kills, I compensate all for the loss from my own coffers.
Your coffers? Got a store of sons and husbands in there to compensate for those shredded by your beast?
Naturally, I cannot revive the dead, but I do make generous restitution to their loved ones. Just last summer, I paid a leather tooler's widow 800 crones, this unfortunate merchant's family, to be duly indemnified as well.
Claim this to be the last surviving basilisk? How do you figure?
The last of this subspecies. Their population was much larger at one time, see? Before the beech forests were felled.
Mean to suggest a direct correlation between beechwood forest density and basilisk populations?
Indirect, I'd prefer to contend. Beechwood forests are the chief habitat of roe deer, you see. In turn, a staple of the basilisk diet. When roe deer grew scarce, basilisks made humans their staple food. Enter the Witchers. And thus, we've come to this one last specimen. It's a female. As recently as last year, we still had two. But Jocaste's mate passed on, alas.
Jocaste?
Should she not have a name? My father dubbed her in honor of my dear departed mother. Jocaste was brooding then. Two eggs. That she cast from her nest, alas, when the male perished.
Where's the basilisk nesting? Any idea?
Of course I've an idea. But you don't really expect me to tell you. Those are not toy swords. I know your intentions.
Find it myself, then. Easy to track with its distinct paw prints. Mentioned two merchants. So I might also look for the other corpse.
It is so indeed. A wound from a sterling basilisk festers long.
Need to brew a potion that'll neutralize that. Basilisk scales are usually thicker, not nearly so fine. Could be more sensitive to fire, this one.
Alas, it is true. Jocaste has a terrible fear of fire. She's a highly sensitive creature. Rid your mind of any thought to kill her, You would destroy the last of a species.
Busted barrels. Contents spilled all over. Must have been tannin in there. Used to treat leather. Beast smashed the barrels. That's how the scent got on the scale.
Your cocoa is so very curious. Strong scents, especially intrigue her. The barrels, they must have drawn her in. Drawn her to the caravan.
Busted barrels slimed with venom. Almisk must have caught the second. Anyway, got 2 cents. Venom and tannin. Ought to be enough to track the beast.
Why track her at all? Your caste is protected. Her death would forever destabilize the ecosystem. Who knows what would happen? I see unforeseeable consequences down the line. Simply refrain from provoking her. Harm her not, and she too will leave you untouched. I've long suspected they do it on purpose. Scent their goods. They seek to lure the basilisk to destroy their wares. It allows them to demand compensation from their assurers.
In search of herbs for a new flavored wine. Well, suddenly...
Calm down. It's over.
The Bang Diddlers kidnapped me. In hopes of collecting a ransom, I'm sure. But with Master Liam's troubles, he never could have paid them. Ah, but I'm free and safe. Thanks to you. Should you need any help? I've a hearty stock at the Coronata. Will you walk me there?
Need to look around here some more, but I'll be sure to stop by if I'm ever in the area.
I shall be waiting.
I owe you my life, unknown knight. How are you dubbed?
Dubbed Geralt. Geralt of Rivia.
My thanks, Sir Geralt. The scallywags thought to demolish our herb garden, you see. I thought I shall take a hum, scare the rabble off, but to my great chagrin, there were too many and I failed. There's no use crying over spilt wine. Come with me to Vormentino. I'll patch up your armor or pound the anvil to fulfill some other need you might have.
Go ahead. I'll stop by when I'm in the area.
Prophet Lebiota!
What? Lost your nerve?
Thank you.
That's it, Roach.
Master Witcher, have you any news?
Coronado's and Vermentino's troubles didn't come out of nowhere. Found evidence someone was behind them. Specifically, someone planted Arcospore bulbs around the properties. That's in these letters. As for who it was...
What do you mean, who? Him! And only him!
You're mad, woman! Surely you hatched this plot and now seek to stick me with the blame!
Calm down. Both of you. I'll find the place the letters mention. We'll clear this up. This vineyard, Belgard, why is it so valuable?
You are not from here. It certainly shows. Before Count Crespi fell prey to the beast, Belgard belonged to him. As a man of wealth and influence, he guided it to immense success, brought in rare grape varieties, hired skilled workers. I shan't trouble you with unnecessary details. Suffice to say that merging Belgard with another vineyard is a sure recipe for success.
Solved your problems. Coronado and Vermentino can both go back to operating normally.
What's this? Both vineyards? Why, that puts me in quite a bind.
Then let me release you. Sell Belgard to me.
Out of the question.
Quiet! Do not dare to start that again, or I'll not sell to either of you. In light of the situation, I would advise the parties to form a partnership.
What?
You heard me. A partnership. That is my final decision. Now please, come with me. I shall show you your new property.
Hang on. What about my pay?
A word once given. The job is done. The pay is due. Take it.
Just a minute. You got us into this bind. So now you must come and see it through. I've a strong sense we'll soon have more work for you. Me and my dog-dittered new partner.
Join you later. Need to tend to something else first.
That's it, Roach.
Chin and a cool some rot.
Aim to hop on a horse after making merry. Welcome to my humble establishment. What land do you hail from?
Been on the road so long, don't know how to answer that. Let's just say I'm from the north.
Ah, is it true what they say? About the war, death, destruction all about?
Exaggerated. Not by much, though.
Oh, forgive my asking, but I family in Edern, see? So I'm curious. But please, do tell me what I can do for you.
Mentioned you have a family in Edern. Whereabout, if you don't mind my asking?
In Vengeberg? You've been there, perhaps?
Yeah, number of times. It's the hometown of my... someone very dear to me. At any rate, pretty town, Vengeberg. Also didn't suffer too much during the invasion, from what I know.
Oh, that is a relief to hear. A weight off my shoulders, I tell you.
Show me what you're selling. Gwent? Up for a quick match, maybe?
making merry.
What's that?
Mind showing me your wares? Gwent, interested in a round or two?
Bargains, preferential financing from the Cianfanellis on every armor purchase.
That's it, Roach.
Centipede spawning ground. Should destroy it. Looks like an Orcus spore killed him. Should search the body. suggests a third party's behind the troubles at Liam's and Matilda's. And I'm no longer likely to find out. Damn it. Faster.
Thank you.
blades on your back. Help us! Look, monsters all about!
Come on, Roach. Whoa there, Roach.
My desire for Belgard to pass into capable hands was no idle whim, for the vineyard's fallen upon hard times since its previous owner's demise. I've been told of workers dying on their rounds, monsters prowling about. Before anyone can call this home, they will have to deal with these, inconveniences. That is the minister's wish.
More work for me, I guess.
It certainly seems so. But if we're to make anything of this partnership, in itself a difficult notion, we must be able to work without hindrance or threat.
Will you help our fragile consortium?
I can help, sure, but I won't work for free.
Bit less? Is that out of the question? Fine. We have a deal.
More or less already agreed, I guess.
That's a weight off my chest, I must say. Your reward shall be fair, I promise.
I'll get to work.
Pink Lipiota! We're saved, my hero.
No hero, just a witcher. Slaying monsters is my job.
Brave and humble! Oh my! Oh!
What are you offering? What can I buy?
The best herbs in all Toussaint!
Run this vineyard all by our lonesome?
Oh, no. My father's the vintner. Oh, an excellent one, too. I merely help out.
So where's your father?
In the hospital. After he was wounded by those monsters. But he gets better by the day.
Take care.
Please, do stop in if you're ever around.
Where'd you get them cutty peepers?
Show me what you got.
Greetings, traveler. Have you any needs?
Mind if I glance at what you got? So long.
Good luck on the path.
Somehow Ethan made our ladies more eager. A thousand thanks, White One.
That's hard on the nerves, eh? That's why you're so great.
it.
Thank you.
Something's humming. Place of power. It's gotta be.
Thank you, sir. Were it not for you, well, those bandits were not pulling pranks. I could pound some new steel for you in gratitude, but I must first return to my workshop in Belgard.
Drop by when I'm in the area.
Myself, I like
stuff. Cox and the whip await those running riot.
Welcome, Snow White. Wish to look over my goods?
Mind if I glance at your stock? See ya.
Eh? What's that?
So long.
Justin, jewel encrusted Galligaskin. The latest break.
See you in Belgard.
All's well at Belgard. Took care of the problems.
Splendid. And thus, officially, by the power vested in me, I grant you title to the Belgard Vineyard, and trust that you shall make good use of its grounds and resources. Thank you. Oh, I can already taste this vineyard's first young wines. Scrumptious.
Don't let the vapors go to your head. Witcher, your pay. The amount we agreed. Forgive me. I must get to work. Look over the supplier's bids. Liam was to do it, but he's busy, as you can see.
I fear this will not be an easy partnership. I just hope we don't end up killing one another. All the same, I thank you for your help.
Good luck. So long.
Master Witcher, the debt I owe I can never hope to repay, not in all my life. First, you ripped me from the Hunter's clutches. Now, thanks to you, the vineyard prospers like never before. You, sir, are owed a very good price on my goods.
What were you doing in the Karaberta woods? And how'd you wind up a prisoner of those bandits?
Ever since the Count died, I've not had the resources to buy raw materials, meaning no new barrel hoops, no tools. So I mustered a few lads and went into the woods to scavenge. Great deal of scrap to be had in those elfin ruins, if you don't mind digging. Folk say the place is haunted, but I've no fear of elfin ghosts.
A rational man.
Rational or superstitious, it matters not. The point is, I did not see a single ghost. Yet a Hansa, yes, that we ran into. Though it seems I've more luck than sense, because you came along to save me.
See ya.
And chops! The more you beat them, the better they are!